this universe, our galaxies, they are those pieces, and then due to inertia, gravity, they started revolving these detailed theories. But my question is this, that small particles are the big particle. Suppose it was big or small an object. Due to blast, it has given existence to all these galaxies. Okay? My question is this, from where this object came? Okay? Galaxies came out from this object. But from where this object came? Question. Now, what does logic say? There should be some father of Adam, and if there is no father, then there must be some creator.
Mother. Then creator.
There must be any creator, and that creator should be independent. If the creator is not independent, then again creation, creator became creature, again creature. So Adam alayhis salam, if the history told that he has no father, then he is created by some power, and that power should be independent. And then we see about the first tree. The first tree, how it came into being?
Natural.
By any creator, it was also created. And that creator should be independent. And this object, the first one object, from where it came, it says that there is some creator of this object. And that creator should be independent, and the creator should be more powerful than creatures. Creator should be more powerful than these creatures. Now here, we reached to a point, even you are taking any object, tiny or huge, of this universe, and then you are going to the back research. You will reach the same point, that first time this object, how it came into being. There is the question, and we are saying that there must be any creator. And that creator should be independent. That creator should be more powerful than these creatures. Now see, ancestry of Allah. As we are discussing, creator should be independent.
No ancestors.
So, there should be no creator for the creator. That's why there is no ancestry for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, power of Allah. As we are discussing, that creator should be more powerful than these creatures. And nowadays, as we know, atomic bomb, hydrogen bomb, and about that blast, we are not able to understand the powers of this universe. So the creator should be more powerful than all these powers. That's why this power, power of Allah, is unlimited. And now here is the question, someone can say, there is one creator of Adam, one creator of plants, one creator of the sun, one creator of the earth, there are too many, it is possible there should be too many creators. Logic says this. But again, I want to say, Logically, it is not possible. Why? Because since thousands, millions of years, this universe is created and it is working. Leave the human beings, rest of all things, we will include human beings, but rest of all things, they are working with harmony, balance. Never they fought with one another. Never ever there is such kind of disturbance. Even you are taking a particle of sand and researching on it, and you are taking a leaf of any tree, you are studying it, it is leading towards any other power. If there would be different creators, one creator for human beings, one for plants, one for other things, then there would be conflict between those creators. The creator of human beings can say they don't protect plants, don't crop them, don't do care of them, because me and the other creator, we are little bit angry with one another. And the creator of heavens is saying that for 2 years, 5 years, there will be no rain. And the creator of animals is saying, okay, eat all human beings because we have conflict with one another. So it is quite natural when there will be two powers, there will be conflict between powers. And that conflict will deepen with the passage of time, and ultimately there will be collapse between those two powers. If we study this universe from millions of years, it shows the harmony, the balance shows that they are controlled by one power. And that one power, that is the creator. And that creator should be the cherisher. If the creator is not cherisher, then that is not creator. As mother, every mother is cherisher of her baby. She is feeding him, giving food from her breast, from the other belongings. Mother in Arabic, it is the word Rabb.
Same father also.
Rabbatun, mother, and Rabbun, father. In your Ikamal, it is written Rabbul Usra.
Yes, yes.
So, why the father is called Rabb or mother is called Rabbatun? They are feeding their children. Rabb means cherisher. So, the one who is creator, he has arranged all those things which are required by all creatures. They are human beings, they are animals, they are plants. They need sunlight, they need oxygen, they need carbon dioxide, they need water. Whatever they need, all the requirements are provided by the creator. That's why that creator is the cherisher, and we say Rabb. And Allah says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. That Allah is not the Rabb of Muslimin, He is Rabb of Alameen. In Alameen, all kind of creatures are included. So if the sun needs something for its survival, we cannot provide sun, but Allah is providing him. If the galaxies, they need something for their survival, whether it is gravitational force or something else, which still not studied by science, Allah is providing that. And even, which is well known thing, if some insect